Blood, blood on your hands.
AMC, shame on you.
Blood, blood on
AMC, shame on you.
Blood, blood on your hands.
AMC, shame on you.
Blood, blood on your hands.
AMC, shame on you.
Blood, blood on your hands.
Justice for the South African miners. Justice for
South African miners.
Justice for in South Africa, in particular the miners, is continuing unabated by the regime, and in particular by the ANC, who are governing the country. And there are many people here today who have come from different political backgrounds and none who came to express their solidarity with the miners and their opposition to the regime, represented inside by the South African ambassador. We have an open letter here to the ambassador and anybody either who's here with us, who hasn't signed it, or indeed any member of the public who's passing, who wishes to sign it and express their solidarity with the miners. It very simply says, we wish to strongly express our protest to the ambassador of South Africa and Ireland. Following the appalling police massacres of 34 miners in Marikana on the 16th of August, we hear the dreadful news that 4 more miners have been shot and wounded by security guards at Modder East in the East Rand. This comes on foot of the bizarre and sickening charging under an old apartheid law of 270 Marikana miners with the murder of their fellow workers. Fortunately, these monstrous charges have been dropped. This terrible treatment of workers must stop, and we call for an end to state violence against workers, a truly independent tribunal of inquiry, and the reinstatement of jobs and decent wages for the South African miners.
First of all, can I say, I'm delighted to be here this afternoon, and the Irish Congress of Trade Unions and the President of the Irish Congress of Trade Unions, Dougie McGlone, sends his solidarity to this demonstration and fully supports the campaign. He makes the point that while people before would have been our friends, the fact that they may have been our friends at the ANC and they treat ordinary workers like this, we shouldn't stand idly by and not protest. And we support that thoroughly. We also had a statement from Joe Costlow. We tried to get a statement from Eamon Gilmore and put pressure onto him to do something and called back the South African ambassador. But the best we could get was a statement from Joe Costlow saying that he would take this message back to the minister and would do something within the next couple of days. That was over 10 days ago and nothing has happened. We've all seen on the television this morning about how the miners were cornered and then murdered, and how they were attacked and how for standing up for their rights. We all here believe in democracy. We all have had our own bloody Sundays, and we know what happened even if there is an inquiry into this murder and killing of the miners. This will be a cover-up will take place, and they will do, as they always do in cases like this, blame the people who are protesting and looking for justice for themselves. They try and throw the blame back onto them. It was all your fault. You started it. We didn't shoot first. We know that the attempts are going to be made to do that.
I'm going to be very brief. It's with a sense of deep disappointment, I think, more than anything else, that we find ourselves back here again talking about South Africa. Disappointment because South Africa should know better. Of all the countries in the world, they should know better than to do what they did at the Marikana mines. They've seen many slaughters down through the years, and they know where it gets them, and it brings people like us out onto the street, and it brings people out in protest, and so it should.
It's really important, the question of international solidarity, and you can see how international solidarity, protests around the world, together with the explosion of rage that has now happened in South Africa, the expansion of the strike into the gold mines, has put the ANC under pressure, whereby now, today, they're saying that they will release the remainder of the miners that they're talking about charging with murder. And that is a product of international pressure, international solidarity, as well as the movements within South Africa itself. But the fact that it could even be considered, like Breeder was saying, apartheid laws being used to charge the comrades of those who were killed by the police with their murder, somehow that their accomplices in their murder, shows how far the situation has gone. It shows how far the ANC government has moved to the right, and exposes the reality now of what exists in South Africa, whereby under the ANC, the state machinery in reality has been turned into private security guards for the mines, where the ANC leaders are working hand in glove with the leaders of the multinationals, as personified by Cyril Ramaphosa, a leader of the ANC, sitting on the board of Lonmin, responsible for this, for the attacks on the workers, working hand in glove with the state in terms of this massacre. A company that is crying all over the international media about how their profits are challenged, giving out about the miners' struggles, and how, despite all of that, if you read the profit reports, they're going to make $600 million in profits this year, made from super exploitation of workers in South Africa and elsewhere who work in extremely dangerous, unsafe conditions, who live in slums, in shacks constructed beside the mines in absolute misery while they cream off the profits at the top.
And I think it clarifies something that probably most of all of us know, but which I think is so important as a message that we have to get across in the workers' movement across the world today. And that is that unless the question of challenging capitalism and redistributing the wealth in society and the economic resources in society, unless that is at the heart of any movement for change, any movement of resistance, then you don't really get the change for the vast majority of people. And that's not just an issue for South Africa at the moment, but it's an issue right across Europe. As the ruling class in Europe try to rain down vicious austerity on working people, they're doing it across the world, as their answer to the crisis that they've created is to attack working people. We need to understand that there has to be an internationalist response to the offensive of the rich and of capitalist states across the world, because they will try and isolate movements of resistance and demonize them. That's what they're doing to these South African miners, to say that they were troublemakers, that they were violent, they were being unreasonable and so on. And that's what they're doing to any movement of resistance. Even the forces of the left in this country, their answer to our criticism of the injustice they're visiting of ordinary people is to demonize us, to ridicule us, to try and undermine the struggles of ordinary people for fair play and justice. And our response to that has to be internationalism, and to say that the real division in this world is between the rich and the poor, between the ordinary working people and the corporate vultures and vampires who are willing to sacrifice democracy, justice, human decency in order to protect a system that is driven by nothing but greed for profit.
You're getting a bit older in the struggle. I think you have a long memory. And I remember Lonmin, the mining company involved here. Lonmin used to be called Lonro. I don't know if the younger people will remember them. But they have been exploiting African workers for decades. Right back in the early 70s, Lonro was convicted of sanctions busting with Rhodesia, the illegal racist white settler regime of Rhodesia. Lonro was involved in sanctions busting, and they're all in it together, these sort of people. On the board of Lonro, and it ended his career when this happened, was Sir Angus Ogilvie, who was a member of the British royal family, as it happens. They're memories from the past, but these things don't change. Certain leopards do not change their spots, and Lonmin change their name, but not their practices, that needs saying. The other thing I just wanted to read out to you is, I won't read it all, it's a long statement, but some extracts from a very powerful statement by Jay Naidu. Jay Naidu was the General Secretary of the Congress of South African Trade Unions in the struggle against apartheid. And he's just issued an open letter to his trade union. He says, "My conscience as one of your founding leaders begs me to reflect on the state of our country and nation. The Marikana massacre is a deadly body blow to the democratic social fabric, and it leaves my heart heavy with sadness. The weight of the disappointment is staggering as I think back to my political initiation as a teenager, listening to the powerful political narrative of Steve Biko. We have nothing to lose but our chains. He presented a bold, courageous vision of a free South Africa. We were inspired as a generation to stand up and be counted irrespective of the cost. So where are the courageous leaders of today? The 1976 Soweto student uprisings were our Tahrir Square. We were smashed, but we came back and kept building on the foundations of the sacrifices of Nelson Mandela and his generation. We painstakingly built a mass movement. It took us 18 years to build our liberation movement and place Nelson Mandela as South Africa's first democratically elected president. Now, 18 years later, we commemorate a new massacre under the watch of the supposedly democratic government we elected. I, like many South Africans, am devastated. Yet it can't be denied that the writing has been on the wall for some time. Why did we choose to ignore the signs? He then goes on to offer a devastating indictment of the poverty, the inequality, the terrible education, the unemployment, the treatment of the black South African working people and poor by the government. And he then closes with a quotation from Nelson Mandela, which I think is applicable to us all. I've got it. Thanks, Pete. Right. Poverty, like apartheid, is not an accident. Like slavery, it is man-made and can be removed by the actions of human beings. The key now is for those human beings to take the appropriate action. And those words from Mandela, from Jay Naidu in this situation, I think, speak to us. They speak to our trade union leaders here. They speak internationally. So,
organise a delegation to hand in the letter to the South African ambassador. ANC, shame on you!
Blood, blood on your hands!
ANC, shame on you!
Blood!